Hey, kids! I'm Molesto the Sex Crime Dog! I'm here to teach you how to keep bad people's paws off your wee-wees, your VGs, or your TTs! So never leave home without your bad touch stickers!
Hey, this is the wrong show. Ah, this is the right one! As you were. Paradise PD, sorry for the confusion, it's quite easy to get mixed up with Pickleberry, since they're both created by Roger Blank and Wacko Eugene. Is that how you pronounce his name? Eugene? But Pickleberry was made for Comedy Central, and it's basically copied change of characters and plot and renamed to Paradise PD for Netflix. Good old Netflix. Hey, my name is Jay Finlayson and welcome to my first review video, a review of Paradise PD. So if you're ever wondering what to watch and have access to your ex's Netflix account, don't worry, I've got you covered. Paradise PD is not only brought to us by the same team who created Comedy Central's Pickleberry, but basically it's the same thing without the restraining rules to follow for it to be aired on the TV. The Forest Rangers of Pickleberry have been replaced by a police force that engage in a tasteless comedic misadventure filled with gore, sex and drugs. A lot like my Saturday nights, you know. It gets wild. Some horrors and my inhalers. Crazy times.
God damn, I love inventory!
Paradise PD follows Kevin Crawford's attempt to seek approval from SpongeBob. His dad, Randall Crawford. But things get tricky since 13 years ago, Kevin shot his dad right in the, the manhood. Ouch. The show isn't exactly all that funny, to be honest, but we follow some great characters who have their moments, like Paradise's best cop, the awfully aggressive Gina Jabowski, who is played by Sarah Chalk. Stupidly horrendous at pronouncing names, but it's our favourite Barbie doctor from Scrubs. Gina has a weird and strange sexual attraction to Dusty Marole, who is so oblivious to what's going on around him. Dusty rather lives in his own world surrounded by his cats. Then we have Gerald Fitzgerald, who is so paralysed with PTSD, he can't do anything other than bitch and moan. However, there's an episode where they just portray the media outlet so well, using Fitzgerald as the main character for the plot. Finally, we have the canine officer, Bullet. What can I say about him? Well, just think of Charlie Sheen as a dog. Even though the storyline throughout the season is predictable and boring, I still enjoyed the whole thing. It had its moments, it made me laugh a little, and I'll recommend it as background noise when you have your mates over playing some Dungeons and Dragons. That's if you have mates. Anyway, like this review, leave a like, and subscribe for more reviews like it. Don't like it, leave creative criticism in the comments section below, because, you know, creative criticism helps me, like, make this stuff better. My aim is to create short, simple reviews which you're not spending like 10 minutes to learn if you should watch it or not. But that's just my little mission. See you next time, where I review the uses of whiteboards. I find them remarkable. Pussy.